Happy Trans Awareness Week, everyone. I want to start off this video by just saying how proud I am of each and every one of you who's watching this video. Whether you identify as LGBTQ+, or an ally like me, you are valid, loved, and supported. I want to encourage you to continue to follow your passions, dreams, and be your authentic self. Because the most beautiful you is the you that you know you are. In case you didn't know, my name is Sander Jennings, and I am the proud big brother of my transgender sister, Jazz Jennings. Jazz was assigned male at birth, but from the moment she could express herself, she knew she was a girl. My allyship journey began when my sister began her social transition at the age of 5. I was approximately 8 years old, and I didn't really know what was going on. My parents told me that my brother was now going to be my sister. Immediately, I was confused because I didn't really know what that meant, and I didn't know much about gender. But of course, I listened to my parents, and I was supportive of Jazz right off the bat. Then, about a year later, we were approached to go on a TV special on 2020 with Barbara Walters. Rather than think about it as, oh, I get to be the proud big brother to my transgender sister, I thought of it as, oh my god, I get to be on TV. And in fact, when they were filming the special, me and my brother were a little angry when we weren't getting any attention. I shouldn't be too hard on myself because I was only 7 years old when we were first approached to be on TV, and that's normal to want to be on TV. At the same time, I look at it now and I know that my true purpose and my true role is to be the best ally possible and the best leader for the LGBTQ+ community possible. Because it's a shame that only 1 in 4 people say they know someone who's transgender. We need people to be not afraid to come out and be their authentic self. And it all starts with us. Us sharing our journey, us being allies, us being LGBTQ+, and being proud of our story. After the 2020 Barbara Walters specials, we were on a few more specials, such as the Oprah Winfrey Network special and another special with Barbara Walters. It was during this time that I began maturing and realizing what was going on. I continued to support Jazz, I stuck up to bullies, and I was the best brother possible. But still, I wasn't able to really fully distinct between how to be the best ally possible. I just thought of myself as, I'm gonna support my sister, but never thought about it as, hey, I could serve as a really big role model to the rest of the LGBTQ+ community and to siblings of LGBTQ+ individuals. Fast forward to 2015, and my family began on I Am Jazz on TLC. This was a life-changing moment where our platform grew tremendously, and we had the ability to reach a lot more people through social media and through the show. Even when I Am Jazz began, I still thought of it kind of as, it's fun to be on TV, I like being on TV, and I'm gonna always be supportive of my sister, so I like being a role model. But I really never recognized how important it was to share my story and my allyship journey and who I was as a person. I didn't have a role model to look up to who was a LGBTQ+ sibling, an ally to an LGBTQ+ person. There were no role models. It wasn't until about 2 years ago that I recognized that it was so important that I used my voice to show siblings of LGBTQ+ people that there are other people like them, and show them how to be the best supporter to your LGBTQ+ sibling. To show people that it is okay to be your authentic self, and that it is okay to support the LGBTQ+ community even if you don't identify as LGBTQ+. I wish I would have had these type of resources, and that's why I'm trying to provide them for people today. So as I said, about 2 years ago, I recognized my voice and my influence, and now I've taken the steps to show active allyship whenever possible. Whenever the TLC cameras are around, it's never about, oh, there's cameras around, I get to be on TV. Now it's about, how can I share the best message possible to help change the world in the best way possible? Even just this past week, I'm still educating myself and learning how to be the best ally possible. For example, I recently learned about the distinction between a brave space and a safe space, which I talk about in some of my videos on TikTok and Instagram. And about a month ago, I learned about the distinction between performative allyship and authentic allyship. I'm a maturing ally, but I'm also trying to help mature all other allies. So I really hope you'll go check out all my other content and that you're inspired to be the best ally possible. And if you are LGBTQ+, please share this with an ally of yours so then they can watch this and then go watch all my other allyship videos. I love you guys all so much, and thanks for watching this video. I hope you learned something from my allyship